is Giana from Lofty Life, and I am her mother, Dion. And today we are bringing you a video, our very first video. And this is going to be a tutorial on a protein treatment that we're going to do on her hair to get her ready for the winter.
So we set this up as a nice little salon treatment for her. She has a couple books she's going to browse through when she's under the dryer. And we have her favorite radio station, the Kids Bop channel, playing. Okay, can you say hi, Giana? All right. So this style that she has in now is a old style that we did about 3 days ago. And what we do in between is just smooth her edges in the morning when she's going to school and put maybe a little bit of product, either a pomade or a nice gel, to lay down this area, which is the area that generally gets frizzy on her. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to coat my hands with a little bit of avocado oil. Do not laugh at your mother. And that is going to help me while I detangle her hair. Now, she got a couple new things. You want to tell them why you picked this?
I picked this one to match my boots to my outfit. And I also have a pink sparkling one and one that looks like a cheetah.
Ooh.
I also have half of an emoji necklace. It's a friendship necklace.
You guys have an emoji theme going on today.
Yeah. And I got my clip-on.
An emoji clip-on?
Yep.
And you have your emoji dress.
And it's reversible.
Cool. So we're going to take these braids down first. And with putting the avocado oil on our hands, it just gives us a little bit of slip. And then we're going to take the top ponies out. And then for our tools, we have a comb for parting. We have a wide-tooth comb for detangling.
We have a wet brush.
And we got that one new because the other one was starting to feel like it was snagging a little bit. And then we do use a bristle brush, usually just to smooth down the fronts. We don't brush it all the way through the curls. So those are the tools that we're using today. Generally, another thing we use a lot is a spray bottle if we're styling from dry hair. But today we're going to start with wet hair after we're done with the detangling process. If you don't have a hooded dryer, you can just use a cap, and if you put like a microfiber towel on top of that, it'll create some heat. But we do have a hooded dryer, and those can be found at Sally's, and they're really only like $130. So that's something you could invest in. For my hair type, my hair does really good with heat conditioning.
Yes, sir. I'm going to use my rainbow moon. They're rubber bands that are small. Like if your child has a rainbow moon, like it's something where you twist it and then you put another one on top and then you lift the one that's twisted over it. And you have to keep putting straight ones on, not keep twisting.
Yep, so that is how you make some bracelets.
Yep.
So now we have her hair down and we can kind of separate the clumps. And it's always a good idea to do detangling in sections, and we've been taking really good care of these beautiful models' hair. So she doesn't have a lot of tangles right now because we did, you know, set her hair. And you don't necessarily have to do a shampoo. As I'm looking at her hair right now, it's not very dirty, so she really could get away with just doing a conditioner wash, and we might just do that instead. Now that I'm seeing her hair, and this is the detangling spray, so let's just give that a spritz and let's see if she has any areas that we need to work this through. We like to do all of our detangling with really wet hair. We found that that is the easiest. It crosses the least amount of tension and breakage for her.
Also, the rainbow loops can be used on braids and stuff for ponytails.
Yep, so we found a style that we are going to try to recreate on Pinterest. And if you follow us on Pinterest, the Lofty Life, on our Pinterest page, that's where we'll pin the looks that we are going to try to recreate. We did a super cute braid look the other week.
So, it was like there was a cross on this side, so a braid would go
outfit. Yep. So we did two braids at the crown, and that's something you'll see from us a lot because we recognize that that front area of her hair is an area that tends to tangle up. And you'll notice that when I'm detangling, I'm starting at the roots, and then I'm working my way up her hair. And that way, she's not having any discomfort, and we're nicely working through the section. So I'll do about half of this size, and then I'm going to come back and do this back section. If she does have tangles, generally this back section is an area that we'll see more tangles in. Sure.
I also like, she puts oil down my scalp because it's normally like dry.
Yep, so we can moisturize her scalp as well. And that's really all it takes. Just start at those ends, brush them out, and work your way up. And just take your time. And it helps if you have a really well-behaved child like Giana that lets you sit, she sits still and she's not whining, because then you don't get flustered and frustrated as well. So then it's easier for you to take your time.
I also do have a sister, and I don't know where she is.
Misha.
She might come. We might do a little of her hair in this video. I'm not sure yet.
So we're going to do the same thing on this side, simply working from the ends up to detangle.
Wow, be careful.
So the style we're going to try today, we're going to do probably about four little braids in the front of her hair, and then we're going to have the back of her hair down. And when we're setting the hair, what we like to do is let it dry completely in a braid, even the portion that we know we're going to eventually let down. Okay. All right. Let me see that. So now her hair is completely detangled, and we're going to go to washing it. We'll be back after we wash it. We're going to concentrate the product on her scalp, and then we're just going to rinse it through the ends. And we'll be back with wet hair. And then from there, we're going to put that protein treatment in, and Giana will go under the dryer. See you in a minute.